great kids, their kids go to college and all sorts of stuff. But somewhere in their life, there was a point where they had a decision to make. They can go left or right on this path. Left was the easy route. Right was the hard route. A lot of people take the easy route. And they had a good life that way, but the better life was going to the right side. And you may have 20 years of pain and suffering to get past it, but a lot of us die never truly starting our journey. You gotta start your journey. It may suck, but it will come out the other side where you're coasting. Every day, we're seeing who we are as people. When I was growing up, I lied for people to accept me because I didn't accept myself. So I would make up stories so that you would accept me into your world. I would, everything I did was for someone else to like me. It wasn't until I started reading my own book about how pathetic I was as a human being. I could blame my dad, I could blame kids at school, I could blame having health issues, ADD, my mom not being around. I could blame a lot of people. And that's the book I was reading. And I put it off on everybody else. It wasn't until I said, you know what, for me to fix this, I gotta read what the fuck is wrong with David Goggins. Not blame anybody. Read my book, it's okay. I'm afraid of my shadow. How can I overcome that? Go in the military, get your ass kicked. Do things you hate to do. Be uncomfortable every fucking day of your life. Roger that. I'm not the smartest kid in the world. Okay. Instead of somebody saying, oh no, you're smart. No, don't say that to yourself. I said to myself, no, I'm a dumb motherfucker. Okay, roger that. How you get smarter? Educate yourself. So the things that we run from the truth. We're running from the truth, man. So the only way I became successful was going towards the truth. As painful and as brutal as it is, it changed me. It allowed me to become, in my own right, who I am today. I knew nothing about ultra marathons. I hadn't even run a marathon. I knew nothing about this world. So I Googled the top 10 hardest races in the world. And what comes up is the Badwater 135. It's a 135-mile race through Death Valley in the summertime. I thought it was a race where you run like 20 miles, set up camp, you know, barbecue outside, and then go run some more the next day. So I called the race director up at the race and said, hey, Chris, his name is Chris Costner, I want to do your race.